Hello animators, in today's episode we're gonna talk about how to draw anything in one point perspective, and I'm gonna cover some common questions as well, such as how to draw a cylinder, circle, arc or curve in one point perspective, or how to subtract a volume from another, or how to draw the same volume in depth while we're keeping the same distance, or how to draw a volume relative to another. So let's not waste time and get started. Here we have 9 rectangles and we want to convert them into 9 cubes. First of all, you have to draw a point in the middle. We call this point vanishing point. Then you have to draw some lines from the corners to the vanishing point. Next, you need to decide how deep they're gonna be. For example, this much. In one point perspective, whenever you want to draw a vertical line, you have to draw vertical. If it's a horizontal line, you have to draw it horizontal. But if you want to draw something in depth, your line should go through a vanishing point. Now that we know how deep it is, we can draw the vertical line and horizontal line. Let's do the same to other cubes. Now we can clearly see the edges, and it's time to fill the shapes and remove extra lines. There it is, we have 9 cubes in one point perspective. This time we want to draw some electric posts with the same distance. Since the ground is in depth, we have to draw its lines through the vanishing point. Now let's put the first electric post. It's a vertical line because it doesn't go in depth. But by drawing this line, we can find the maximum height of every electric post. Now you have to decide how much is the distance. It's completely up to you. Let's say, for example, this much. To find the center of every electric post, the first thing you should do is to mark the center of the first one, then draw a line from there to vanishing point, and there it is. To find the place of the next electric post, you have to draw a line from the top of the first electric post to the middle of the second one, and then continue it until it intersects the bottom line. Now we can place the third one. Draw a line from the top of the second one into the middle of the third one, and continue it, and then we find next. And just do this for a few more times and you'll find the place of all. Now that we know where to draw electric posts, we can draw them perfectly. And let's remove the extra lines and add some wires. And note that the farther something is from us, the smaller it is, and the closer it is, the bigger it is. Even something like wires and the width of the wires follow this rule. And another thing is that in one point perspective, we always draw the horizontal line. It always passes through the vanishing point, and it helps us to have an idea of where things vanish. That's why we call that point vanishing point. Here we have a cube in one point perspective and we want to draw a circle on it. First of all, cross on the rectangle that is on the upper face of the cube to find the center of it. And then by drawing a vertical and horizontal line, you'll find the 4 points of the circle. And now it's time to actually draw it. And if you draw a cube on top of this cube, you can draw a cylinder on top of it. It's getting a little bit messy, so let's remove the extra lines again. Now we're gonna subtract a cube from this cube. To begin, we have to draw a rectangle on the front face. Just consider it as a road, so these two lines should go through the vanishing point. And how deep is it, you say, it's up to you. And then it's time to draw vertical and horizontal lines and remove the extra ones. For subtracting a cube from the top face, we have to first remove the cylinder. Let's begin with this horizontal line, the closest one. And then we have to draw these two lines that go through the vanishing point. What do you think of the length of these two lines? Well, the other horizontal line is further, and as I said about the electric post, the horizontal line that is further has a lower distance to edge of the cube, so overall it should be somewhere around here. Let's fill this rectangle. You know the rest, we can draw the vertical lines and decide how much depth it has and draw the horizontal line and remove the extra lines. To draw a volume closer than this one, first you should draw a line that passes one of the corners and goes through the vanishing point. Then you can say I want a distance to be this much and start by drawing its front face. Now you can consider it as one of those 9 cubes. Draw from the corners to the vanishing point, then add the horizontal and vertical lines, and it's done. Here we have an object from the front view and we want to draw it in one point perspective. Did you know that the vanishing point represents the position of your eyes? So if you're tall, your vanishing point is higher. In the 9 cube example, you can see that the vanishing point is upper than this cube. That's why we can see that face on top. If the vanishing point is in the center of the object, you won't be able to see none of its faces. And for the corner cubes, you can see two of their faces. And if the vanishing point is on the right side of the object, you will be able to see the right face of it. So since the vanishing point here is on the right side, we only can see the right face of this object. We're gonna start with the longer line, which is on the left. Then we can add two lines from its both sides to the vanishing point. Next, you should decide how much depth you're gonna need. And now it's time to measure the vertical distances on our object and apply them to the line on the left. After that, draw these lines from the found points to the vanishing point, and then you only need a cross to find the center of the object and a vertical line to find the middle of the curve. For these two, you have to guess, but since one of them is closer, you know that the closer one has a longer distance from the edge, so they should be somewhere around here. Before it gets more messy, let's finish it. In this case, our reference was the front view of the object, but don't be afraid of drawing the other dimensions. And finally, we've got the same object in one-point perspective. That's it for one-point perspective, and today's final sentence is, never say you don't like something unless you've tried it at least once. However, do not try anything, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and see you in the next one! We'll be right back.